Hey boys, hey girls, let's make us, let me see, I gotta look. Play Oreilles De Cochon from this very old cookbook, talk about good. But it's a very old recipe that we're gonna change and modify. There's actually two of them in here, right there. See here? Also known as pig's ears. Okay? So, what we gonna do with them is modify that recipe. First off, what is a pig's ear? It's a pastry. It's not a real pig's ear cut off and fried. This is, think of it as fried pie dough. Yeah. That's what it is, and it's damn good. You sprinkle it with either powdered sugar or your favorite kind of syrup. Dip it in. Sky's the limit. Serve it with jam. Don't matter. Gonna get 2 cups of flour in here. Oh, I got some bread flour. I got more than anything else. Teaspoon of salt, some ground cinnamon. Ground cinnamon and some sugar and a cackle fruit. Gonna get a cackle fruit in that. It'll make a little dough. And we roll it out, watch. Right, so if you feel comfortable making pizza dough, it's about the same thing. Flour you a work surface and flour you a rolling pin. Just like that. Flour it down, flour your hands. And we're gonna be working with a dough. Dough. Cinnamon sugar dough. Think yum. Right? Put him down now. We'll knead it a couple times just for the hell of it. So we can look like a bread maker. Yeah, right. Right? A baker. My great grandpa used to be a baker. Just so you know. Need. You're supposed to fold it and do all that crap. Oh, we really don't need all that. Bust this sumbitch in half. Put half back over there. Take this one and bust it in half. Put half of that back over there. Take this one and bust it in half. And let's see what we got. We want to get a real thin pastry here. Dough thingy. Too big. Bust it in half. Let's try again. I think we're getting closer now. Can you see over there? Yeah, there we go. That's about the size we want. We want it very thin. Don't have to be perfectly round. Just thin. Like that. Okay. So this little recipe gonna make a bunch with 2 cups of flour. We're gonna drop them into some hot oil in a deep fry. Well, you know damn good and well, if I pull the deep fry out, I had to fry some crackle too. Uh-huh. Some Rudolph food. They'll fry some up. Got all them done over there too. Let's go ahead and fry one of these pig's ears. All's back up to temperature. I wanted to fry the cracklings and stuff first, because I know this with the flour on, it's gonna mess this all up. I'm gonna drop them down in the oil. And we're supposed to swirl them around and let them fold up on one another to make them look like a little pig's ear. See in there? And we'll cook them till they're golden brown. Like I made that one too thick. I bet it'll eat just fine. Oh yeah, boy. Put it over a wire rack. And let's drop another one in there. We can also take some powdered sugar. Give it a dust. Kind of like a little donut, huh? It's exactly what they looking like to me. Not looking like sopapillas at this point, but with cinnamon sugar and stuff in them. Yum. Now frying those pig skins in this oil first, also flavored that oil and gave it a nice porky flavor. Which more lard, they gave it a lard flavor, basically. And you want these thin as you can get them. And it flavored that oil. And it's very, very good. Yeah, I modified the recipe new style with a lot of cinnamon and a lot of sugar in it. And add more sugar. Yum. So here they are. They look kind of like old pig's ear. See that? Supposed to cook them for about 30 seconds, it says, but I found 45 works better. And it's a pastry. The dough is light. Fluffy, put ice cream on top. So it's sweet cinnamon. Just eat them like this. Pig's ears. Oreilles De Cochon. Something like that. They're excellent. Pour syrup on them. Eat it with jam or jelly. Folk legend has it that they're great with coffee. Also. And I can see why. Yum.